So this is the aluminium exposition, the last day of the construction. And as you can see, some people have already interesting ideas and the concepts of the stands. There are 6 holes today, but I'm showing you only a little bit what is interesting and where I am actually right now. But generally speaking, you can find so many very interesting, nice stuff, like this one perhaps. So cool. So as you can see, this one have floors, and other ones have like lounges, and everywhere. This one is from the glass, and it's so on. A lot of things. Little bit the sunset is finished, but going after work for some beer maybe somewhere. Finally, I think it's deserved. Ooh, nice actually. Some nice content also for YouTube. Some nice, really nice vibing here by the river of Rhen in Düsseldorf. Having some natural rattle, and here overlooking the river and the bridge itself. Very cool, actually, something different. That's how they're spending time, maybe in Düsseldorf. And that's a little bar over there, actually. So cool. And the panorama of a little bit of the Düsseldorf and the Rhine River.
Good afternoon, everybody. Just another day in Poznan, Poland. Okay, so today is Damiana going back, actually, from Düsseldorf, Germany, and actually, I've got so many things to do. That's why from few days before, Monday, 2 days, 3 days, I think, I didn't make any video because it has been so busy lately at school. And today, I would like to show you about my daily life, daily, calm, boring life. But for me, it's enjoyable. This is my first time experiencing autumn in Poland. Yes, I married with Damian for about 10 years together, but I never been in Poland during autumn. So what I can say that I really enjoy it. You know, it's so many things that, you know, makes me amazed about living in a four season countries. It's nice. Just like this. I know the leaves changing colors, right? Beautiful. And now I am in the area of the Poznan Centrum, which is Adamic Kiewit Swente Marcin Street during the rush hour, and showing you how is the traffic situation. We will have a coffee later on. I think that because of already autumn, the fountain in the middle already getting started to be dried, and the flowers also, and the leaves changing, and this is how situation in the ada Mickiewicz Park. Okay, let's have a coffee. This is how it looks, the traffic situation at 3 p.m. Oh, the weather is so warm today, and this one is the Zamek. So I will go to the coffee shop. I like to hanging around area of 20 Martin Street. Nice Philharmonia. In my opinion, it's clean. It's clean city. So I'll go there in the area of the Eat Street to have a coffee and later on walk in my laptop. So that's in front of me if is Adam Mickiewicz University, you see, because this one is I think city center and also many universities. Yesterday I read, you know, nowadays if you have a calm day, boring lives, and you have people who love you and people that you love surrounds you, so it's, and you have a peaceful morning, peaceful mind, you have a kind of luxury life. Interesting. For me, kind of life, having what I like today, I'm so grateful here. What I don't grateful of living in Poland. So like few days ago I was in Uzon, and I see that there are so many, you know, people are would like to live in Poland. And I read also in a Indonesian group, actually in Facebook, like many Indonesian people are also willing to live in Poland and work in Poland. They even want to pay the agent for about 70 until 100 million in order to work and live in Poland. So I'm lucky I'm married with Polish. I'm lucky married with Damian. I can live, can enjoy my life in Poland. So I'm really grateful for that. I feel like I wanna be a tram driver if I have a possible. But I need to pass certain exam. Looks like so chill driving a tram instead of driving a car. So Damian actually next plan for me, he's gonna send me to the driving school so I can drive by myself in Poland. I've got my international driving license from Indonesia, but seems like I need to study again about, you know, the road rules here and everything. I would love to, but I feel like, okay, the next challenge for me. This is Swente Marcin Street, so many office building, restaurant, and I think that I will go to the coffee shop that is close by here during the rush hour, like this, the traffic situation. I would love to drive, but yeah, let's see. Ramen restaurant is here, I think still closed, and I think this is the coffee shop. I will go here. This is how the pastries here, nice, very nice. Now I'm in the coffee shop. I order one hot cappuccino and brownie with the I don't know, the syrup or something on the top. It's nice. This is the coffee shop. I'm editing my video, coffee, cake in the cafe. Some people also working here. Digital nomad? No, I'm not digital nomad. I just wanna enjoy drinking coffee and working in the cafe. That's it. Ah, look at this one. Nice festival. So this is just like the art galleries on the street in Swente Marcin Street. You sightseeing at the same time, you get educated. Sometimes I really like this street. Ah, it's nice. So many nice, interesting things. Oh. Wow. So cute. I'm so grateful that Damian is back here in Poland and then starting his own business and also collaborate with the Targi company. You know what, during Damian live in Bali for about 10 years, he got his permanent residency or kitab or something like that. He doesn't have any, you know, like opportunity to work as what the local do. Like, you know, he never works in any other company, because I remember that, you know, once he tried to apply a job in the hotel, you know, he got his permanent residency, and I think that he also capable to work in a hospitality tourism industry in Bali. The thing is that, and what makes me sad, you know, when we used to live in Bali, like once he tried to apply job, and I remember that the owner of the hotels in Bali, when he saw Damian CV that he used to work in UK for few years, but when he see Damian's nationality, Damian is not, you know, British or coming from the English speaking countries. They just straightforward, you know, oh, I thought that you, you know, when interview Damian told me that he was so upset because the guy who interviewed him said that, oh, you are not coming from, you know, English speaking country. Damian English is not bad, but just because of, you know, he's not coming from English speaking country and they are, you know, not accepting Damian as the worker, as a, you know, manager or something like that in Bali. The thing is that when you are in Bali, you have a, you know, foreigner in Bali, you have a permanent residency, you never ever able to take a local jobs. It's not like here. When I'm here, I'm married, I got my residency permit, I can work without a permit, work permit, and also I can open any business, just like what police, you know, can do. So the thing is that what I feel here is we are glad to move here because of opportunity. And we talk and we talk and we decided life is not about chasing the sun. You know, even that you live in Bali, but there is no opportunity for you to develop yourself, to, you know, work, just simply to develop yourself. What's the point? So that's why Damian and I were thinking to move somewhere. We were thinking to move to Australia, but the visa cost, because Australia obviously closer to Bali and closer to my family, and I also have a social responsibility with my family. Because due to the high cost of the visa, and Damian and I both, we are foreigners living in Australia, we thinking Australia because of Western countries that close by the Bali, seems like okay, let's move to, you know, we decided let's move to Poland, then let's build our dream in Poland. And you know, even like my parents or my family in Bali always saying like, oh, why do you move to Poland and you've got everything, and even my parents sent me to the school until I got my master degree, and I left everything, simply I left everything, just I want to live here in Poland with Damian. Yes, I just said again, life is not about chasing the sun, but how we growing up together, how we develop together. So this is how I'm grateful for that, seeing that slowly, slowly, you know, where many people always saying like, ah, it's impossible. No, everything is possible if you work hard, if you follow your dreams. And you know, you never give up. That's the thing. One thing that I would like to share to you, that if you are mixed married, you know, like Indonesian with a Polish, or you decided to live in Bali or in Indonesia in general, if the foreigner already get a residency status, either kitas or kitab, you will never ever work as what local do. You never take a Grab driver job. If you are foreigner, you never take any kind of local jobs. The thing is that you have to develop something business based on your suppose. That's what actually Damian and I used to live in Bali. We open travel agent company under my name and under Damian. We used to have a PT PMA. But the thing is that we know that if you are married, opening a PT PMA it's expensive. The life is up and down. Sometimes the economy is down and the business gone bankruptcy. And when you have to, you know, struggle, start from zero. And when Damian were thinking to take a local job in Indonesia, even he has a kitab, he has no ride. So that's why we moved to Poland, and Damian start here from being a taxi Uber. And then after that, you know, it's just like we just find many opportunities here. This is what I'm grateful for. When people saying like, you know, oh, you decide to live in Bali, I said, oh, that's good, that's very good. Just bring lots of money to live there. It's not cheap, really. Even that we are, as the local Balinese, with a basic salary compared with paying the needs, paying the daily needs in Bali, you know, like my cousin, you know, earning a basic salary 3 million, but the basic needs is very expensive. So, you know, many of my cousins in Bali keep asking me, is there any job in Poland and want to move to Poland? And I said that working and living abroad is also not easy. You have to deal with so many things. I'm saying like this, you know, it's not all foreigners living in Bali, they are rich. Just because of they bring a different money currency, it means like they are rich. There are so many things that I learn actually when I live abroad, when I really step out of my comfort zone, set up of my nest. I really, really, you know, learn a lot. Because of, I remember that, you know, I'm married with Damian. And then people in my village always thinking that, ah, you are married with bule, you must have lots of money, or you are married with the rich, you know, because of bule. No, don't treat others as a, you know, like a money making machine or ATM machine. We are all working hard. If you don't work hard, you don't earn anything. So one thing is that when my husband Damian was used to live in Bali, he's not lazy. He was trying to look for a job in many corporate, you know, offices in Bali or in Indonesia in general. But simply like, you know, working and looking for job for the foreigners in Indonesia is you need to know, you know, who is who and who take you here. And sometimes, you know, they are, I remember that someone said to us like, you are foreigners coming to Indonesia, you're supposed to invest something here, you build something here so the locals can work at your company. And seems like a mixed married, like, you know, us, like Damian and I, it's not always, you know, we are rich and coming to Bali with a big loads of money and to, you know, to open a business. Yes, we used to open business, but it's somehow life is not always up like this. But like I told you, sometimes it's the business is bankruptcy, so somehow we also need a job, tak? I know I will get so much hate speech on this. I don't mind. At least I'm honest to you. At least I'm telling what is my thought, that what is we have experienced so far. I would like to say thank you for those of you still watching us until now and listening to us. If you have a dream, follow your dream and work together with your partner, with your husband or with your wife. Nothing is impossible. Everything is possible if you're working hard and never give up. I think that I sounds like a coach, but yeah, this is how it is. I'm so sorry. I'm talking a lot today. It's just because of I'm sharing and I'm caring to you. This is one thing. For those of you, you know, who DM me, send me message that about thinking and planning to marry the bule or marry the foreigners, you have to think about pros and cons. Are you ready for that? And also, I would like to share you about how is our harsh life during in Bali. You know, even like Damian every single day making a video on YouTube, you know, and you know, we are sharing about how it is like life situation, and just because of we are caring to you guys. For those of you who keep watching us until now, I just give you big thumbs up. Thank you so much. And again, life is not always like this, but sometimes life is like this. Right, I think that's all my video today, guys. And Damian is already coming back to Poland, and then I have to cook. I have to be, you know, ready and preparing things for him. It has been a few days I didn't meet Damian. So yeah, I think that's all. It's beautiful, you see, surround me so many green things. Poland is, for me, is a great country to live in. I think that's all my video today, guys. Thanks for watching and see you tomorrow. Bye!